I want to explain to I will tell you in soliloquies and metaphors how much I care for a metaphor, a second, and I knew it would be a lifetime. It felt like I wasn't in my right mind, so I had to use my left brain to make sense of this. Our first day ended with a kiss. I'm thinking, man, ease up. You're moving too fast.
Wish to be politically correct. Because I want an act and ask and never forget. I want to make your congressman a wreck. See, I want to be the donkey riding your elephant's trunk, or maybe we can have a tea party and you can put your tea bags in my Boston Harbor. Speaking of my mouth, my mouth may spit fire, but she discreetly caressed every crevice of your policy underneath your desk in the Oval Office, giving you her best, even letting you Monica Lewinsky all over my dress.
He can make it go fast or slow for you. I love it how he gets me warmed up and ready for action. And when I'm done, he still has me do something and to let me taste some more of his perfection. I take a scratch inside and enjoy every minute. And I love it how he bobs his head up and down and all the things. It goes round and around and just like an anchor drop into the ground. Then it get real good down the floor. Backing that ass up so he can get some warm. And of course, he does. And he wouldn't be him if he kept on the gloves. See, no protection. He likes to give it to you all. It keeps amazing me how amazing he can be. How amazing he can be. How amazing he can be.
Beating off the brakes, licking wherever it takes to make her legs shake in a way she can't fake. Her past niggas were far too bashful. She a low-key nasty girl. I'm the purpose of passion. I made her cream all around me like cash rules. She made me bust Brazil nuts, these ain't cashews. She a teacher, yeah, she a freaker, she wanna be paddled. I pulled out that Houston rocket and made Susie ass choose, she don't wanna lose.
You, ma'am, king, queen, brother, father, son, friend. I know it's been a while since you heard it. Maybe felt like you deserved it. Yes, you. I want to remind you who you are. I know sometimes you get lost, and I sense you trying to find your path. And at last, you radiate shades of greatness, determined to make it. Challenges arise, but I see the fire in your eyes. That smile that says, this is my time.
Yeah.
And I felt it. Today I found out my hero was human, my Superman, my heartbeat, my grandfather. He's beaten. His kryptonite, stage 4 prostate cancer, metastasized beyond treatment. He can't fight anymore. Yet this is the same man I've watched drop kick a heart attack and come back stronger. His resounding will to live has evolved into a quiet yearning for death.
She gets naked for me. She is wet for me. She is ready for me. For me. She talks sensual to me. I talk sensual right back. Too many on my mind. I call her the wrong name.
You went face first into the dirt. Got a scratch on your arm, a bump on your knee. So what? Get up. When they call you darky, spick, engine, chink, whitey, sissy, stupid, fat, or ugly. When those words knock you down, make you angry and slap you around, and make your eyes rain until it floods. So what? Shake that shit off and get up.
A numbers game where players plot to get books paid. Bullshit born on the tongues of racist spade. A tool used to uproot. Look, I'm a poet, so what I'm hearing is, racist-ass bitches plot to uproot niggas from this game. They say, we're killing ourselves. We die because we can't scale and track, sort of like poets and rappers. You know, our words just don't fucking beat the same. We're divided by thin lines like those used to separate laws and races and the funky-ass racist-ass laws when cops lose the space.
Little Johnny! Little Johnny! Lord, he never did nothing wrong.
How the hell did it end up in the words of a Black Snow's poem? Little Johnny, little Johnny, Lord, he never did nothing wrong. How the hell did he end up in the words of a Black Snow's poem? Now, little Johnny was only 16 years old. And to my knowledge, this is the first time his story has ever been told. See, Johnny was a good boy, bringing to his parents pride and joy. Little did they know that a policeman's bullet his young life would destroy. You see, Johnny lived in a neighborhood where the color of his skin made him a usual suspect. Being stopped by the cops was a common occurrence, and this you can bet. And although he hung out on the corners, he never sold crack, smoked weed, and he never got
mad. Every time I finish a poem, I discover I have wings, and effortlessly I start rising, effortlessly I start to heighten. I see more things on the horizon, because my perspective begins to widen. Man, I had to leave the trash and the stink. Left that trash behind me, and I watched that pile start shrinking. I found bread, butter, milk, and honey, and I'm drinking. Landed on a stack of money, and I'm thinking.
I can see you're an amateur. Let a real woman show you how to look good.
Put on that glove!
I will impale myself until your love. Let me lose you with the big blue feather.
A breakup to make up all the inconsistencies I found in the week. So yes, I'm breaking up with myself. It's not about anyone else, because when it's all said and done, the shit hits the fan. I'm the only one that can take the stand and understand what bad choices can do. Bad choices can make you look like a fool. Bad choices can make you feel like someone cook or food or cook or food.
Turn to your silky juices of mind, throbbing mouth, spreading the word. The scent of my need fills the air. A sweet come hither as you commandeer my voluptuous form. Your mouth entices my core. The fluttering of your tongue matching that of my rapid heartbeats. I love the fact that you feel like you have to lick your way to the center of this tantalizing tootsie pop. One, two, three. Continue. Pinching the soft tissue of my Twin Peaks alone escapes me, only to be devoured by your thundering voice in the dark.